Hello, I am Dr. Kavita Srivastava. I am child epileptologist and neurologist at Aditya Birla Memorial Hospital. And today I'll be speaking on creating public awareness about childhood epilepsy on the occasion of International Epilepsy Day. So why do we need to create public awareness regarding this condition? So if you see so many centuries ago, epilepsy was thought to be a disease which is inflicted on a person by some bad spirits, okay? Upri hava, as it was called in Hindi. Because nobody understood why the person is suddenly having such abnormal movements, having uprolling of eyes and having all these kind of violent movements. So they were very frightening to see. And it was because it was not understood. Many people thought that this was actually because of some influence from the demons or the person is possessed by spirits and so on. So that was the understanding till almost 3 or 4 centuries back. After that, gradually, once the research started, people started understanding what is brain, what are the brain networks, okay? That's how the understanding developed. And now we know that there is an excessive neuronal discharge which gives rise to different kinds of abnormal activities which are known as seizures. So there can be different types of seizures, and this modern knowledge about the brain networks has helped us a great deal to know that seizures can have different types at different ages also. So a newborn baby can have seizures. So the conditions which cause seizures will be different across the ages. So what causes these seizures? So you can have two types of seizures. Either there is something acutely going on, insulting the brain, irritating the brain, which will cause seizures. Or because of a prior brain damage, there has been some abnormality in the pathways, which is not present acutely, but it is still giving rise to such an abnormality of the network that they keep on firing spontaneously. And so you get recurrent seizures, and that is what is known as epilepsy. So when you get seizures due to an acute condition, for example, fever in children can give rise to seizures. They are known as febrile seizures. They are not called as epilepsy. If a person gets meningitis, there may be swelling in the brain. If a person gets stroke, there is again irritation of the brain because of the impaired blood supply. So there can be many acute conditions which can give rise to seizures. So they do not require prolonged treatment. They require treatment for the cause as well as very short-term treatment to reduce the irritability of the brain and control the seizures by giving anti-seizure drugs for limited duration. But when there is such an alteration in the pathway, either because of some prior damage or because of altered formation of the brain, that is malformations, or there are certain genetic conditions where these pathways are dysfunctional, so you are getting again and again these discharges and which can give rise to seizures. These are known as genetic causes, channelopathies. So these are the common causes which can operate at any age. Many a times we find that patients are so scared to even reveal this diagnosis even to their relatives because they are ostracized that this person has epilepsy. So as if it is his fault, and as if it is a contagious disorder that somebody else will get it by staying with him. So it is not so. It is just a pathway, the brain network disorder. Just like somebody can get diabetes and it is a chronic condition, similarly epilepsy can be a chronic condition. In children, you may have a self-limiting type which will go away in a few years, or you may have a long standing type just like in adults. So it is not a condition to be ostracized. There is no fault, or there is no actually bad karma of the patient which has given rise to this. So all these myths which are prevalent in the society have to be really curtailed at the grassroots level. Secondly, when you see a person with seizure, I think everybody, just like we say that okay, somebody is pulseless, lying unconscious on the roadside, we all as citizens should be trained to at least attend to the patient till we can get a medical help, till the ambulance can come. Similarly, if a person is seizing, it's the first aid is very simple. You just have to turn the person on one side so that his head becomes low. Okay, just pull the other leg over the leg on the ground so that the person is totally on one side and his head is a little low, so that if there is any saliva and all coming, it will go onto the ground and not be aspirated into the lungs. Seizures are mostly short-lived. They will stop in 2 minutes even if you don't do anything. And but just be with the patient, that no harm is there. Suppose he is in the middle of the road, then just surround him so that doesn't come under a vehicle. If he's on the roadside, just bring him to safety, wait there for 2 minutes, let the convulsion subside. If there is anything visible in the mouth, maybe you can just take it on a handkerchief or something and try to just remove it. If the teeth are clenched, do not try to open it. There is no role of, getting here it's onion, keys and etc. They are just given to the patient to stop the seizure. There is no such role of these things, because the seizures are going to stop by themselves. So epilepsy is a hidden disability. You are labeling them as disabled if they are revealing that they have epilepsy. So if we are more inclusive, I think more people will come out with the history, and we can support them by providing an atmosphere where we can help them to live with epilepsy. So that is the motto of ILAE, which is the International League Against Epilepsy, and this is the occasion where we need to raise lots of public awareness regarding this condition. Almost 5% of people have epilepsy, have seizures, and it is our duty as citizens to know at least the right things about this condition, so that we are not ostracizing the people, we are not under the myths, any wrongdoings to them. Thank you very much.